any mature product that you have in your hands will be less competitive within a year if you don't embrace automation at all stages. Reaching the time to market is a goal. Automation is your key. Hi, I'm Oscar Barrios, Senior Software Engineer specialized in test automation, big fan of agile methodologies and DevOps culture. First of all, I would like to thank the entire SUSE Manager team and especially to my squad. The way we have all been involved in the automation process has allowed us to make great improvements in our workflow, such as the one I have the opportunity to show you today. I would also like to thank SUSE to evolve the SUSECON of this year in that amazing digital format, where every one of you can attend these sessions free and from every place on the planet. All right, so without further ado, let's start the session. On that session, I will share with you how tedious can be the validation of our maintenance updates. Why we had the feeling to be in the Groundhog Day movie, and how we manage to smile when a new maintenance update comes to our hands now. Let's start by understanding why the validation of the maintenance updates are that tedious for us. First, it should be said that every night we pass an automated test suite to our latest product code. This process is called continuous testing, and it's part of continuous iteration, where we generate builds nightly. Anyhow, it's a good practice, actually we make it mandatory, to validate the final build packages before we release them. Therefore, to validate that each maintenance update is stable and secure, we will pass a set of tests. This test suite will not change between validations, as it validates the basic functionality. Our goal is to be able to deliver maintenance updates on a regular basis and short periods of time. This will approach us to the concept of continuous delivery. Many times we found ourselves in the position of needing 3 or 4 team members dedicated exclusively to validate a maintenance update. But it can be even more tricky, because sometimes we had an urgent maintenance incident spot at the same time. So at the end, we require a full dedication of the squad to maintenance tasks. From the point of view of a quality engineer, some months were very, very tough. We could spend a week not writing a line of code in our automated test suite and not doing any exploratory testing for our new features. Those weeks, we dedicate our days only doing manual validation tasks. So we were out from the development cycle, and it was hard to assist our project team on other quality areas during this week. So suddenly someone tell me, hey, we'll have a new maintenance update next week. And do you imagine what it came to my mind every time I know it? Yeah, that's it. Let's start in the movie or Groundhog Day. First, we need to prepare the environment. Prepare the virtual machines to every client supported. For a SUSE Manager server and another virtual machine for the proxy. Second, we need to make sure of using the latest product packages, so we'll need to synchronize all of them, all our products. From this point, we can consider we are in a production environment that is ready to be upgraded using our maintenance update packages, these new packages that we want to validate. So finally, when we have all of that, we bootstrap our new clients and we perform some tests in the clients and on the server. Then put your little hand in mine. Then put your little hand in mine. There ain't no hill or mountain. So yeah, after that funny scene, I think you could got my point when I said that we must automate to survive. And exactly, those steps are always the same. Anyone with the test steps, with the test plan in front of her or him, should be able to perform our test validation. The first to understand what we are doing every time we have a new version to validate is to break down the entire process into stages. That's what we call QAM workflow or pipeline, as it looks like a pipe where our steps are flowing. Very poetic, isn't it? So yeah, we deploy, we check it's all fine on the server, we synchronize our products, we inject our updated packages, we add new activation keys, bootstrap everything, and we run some tests in the clients. In short, our case is a clear example of a methodical but repetitive set of steps. Let's automate it then, right? So here is the graph of the stage. So each stage is a group of steps that for now we are doing manually. Let's be more honest. Okay, we have a set of stages flowing into a pipe. How can that be abstracted and translated into code? Yeah, I know a software that can help us automating it. Are you thinking in the same automation engine that me? Yes, Jenkins and its Jenkins pipelines will offer a way to define as code the different stages to perform in our QAM workflow. On this video, I will not go deeper into that tool. But if you didn't know about Jenkins, I invite you to watch some demos about it. It's very powerful. It's an engine with tons of community plugins and great core feature, the Jenkins pipeline, that allow you to determine what will be the stage to run after the output of the current stage. So you can abort the whole process if a stage is failing, or maybe you want to provide an alternative path of stages. From now on, we'll consider every stage of that workflow as a well-defined stage in our Jenkins code, which is stored in a Git repository. So we'll be able to track any change we make in the Jenkins pipeline. Moving on. Now we'll dive into our pipe and see how can we automate every stage. Let's start by deploying our environment. Our test environment is conformed by a server, a proxy, and a set of clients. We'll create and set up virtual machines for each of them. Also, in order to handle those machines from an isolated environment, from an isolated network, we'll deploy an extra machine. This is what we name controller. So every action made into our server or clients is performed from the controller. Once the server is up, as the new package is still not public, we need to add a new repository to our server, pointing to a temporary internal repository using making use of open build service, where our new packages are located. Then we provide the packages, then we upgrade the packages using zipper command, and in case we need, so in some occasions we will need to take also care of the database schema migration through the spacewalk schema upgrade command. Good. Now, how can we automate all those steps? Here we will use the power of two smart tools, Terraform and Salt. The former, Terraform, will provide a mechanism to provision virtual machines based on a description file. It means we'll be able to describe the operating system installed, the disk size, the memory, network configuration, and everything we need from an infrastructure point of view. The latter, Salt, is a configuration management system, capable to connect to those virtual machines and execute commands on them. So we will use it to track in code all the steps we need to configure on each component. As an example, it will allow us to add a new repository into the server, this temporary repository, and apply the zipper refresh and zipper update command. Finally, and that's just a technical detail, we will pass the URLs of all our internal repositories to the controller, as the controller will need these URLs to inject them in the clients and in the proxy. How can we do that from the user point of view? Jenkins. Thanks to Jenkins, we can pass by parameter those values at the beginning of the stage. So the user, before clicking on the run button of the pipeline, will insert all the internal repositories as text. Actually, in our case, what we do is pass it as a text, but in a JSON format. At this point, our environment is ready and we can start testing it. Let's start by testing the server. From the controller machine, we will open a web browser and we will perform some basic tests in the server, checking if we can create a new organization, create a new user, or retrieve the list of products available, and so on. But we can't automate those steps with the tools we use it for now. We need something different, something capable to navigate into the SUSE Manager website, capable to click buttons, write text on the text fields, or choose an option in a drop-down menu. Also, we need a way to maintain and have track of changes on these test cases. Did you read something about behavior-driven development? If you know about BDD, then you might be familiar with Cucumber framework. If you never listened about it, just stick with the idea that it's a methodology that aims to facilitate the communication with non-technical people in our team member, in our team. What Cucumber frameworks offer is a way to implement BDD in your team. You can write human-readable user stories using natural language. So it allows us to express the behavior and the expected outcomes of a feature and then translate them into code. We'll take advantage of the Cucumber framework to automate all the user interactions with our server in form of commands or using a web browser. In fact, in order to interact with the web browser, we will make use of another framework called Capybara. As you see, we like to use funny names for frameworks. So Capybara Cucumber will allow us to do all kind of tests. The main outcome from here is that we will be able to share the steps we made in an English plain text to everyone in our team. So we can review and discuss these steps with non-technical people. Finally, each of these steps will be translated in a piece of code. This framework can be used with different programming languages, such as Java, Kotlin, or JavaScript. In our case, we are using Ruby. The main reason to use Ruby is that Cucumber was originally written on Ruby, and our regular automated tests were written several years ago. And as we want to reuse some of the steps already implemented, it makes total sense to evolve our current test framework to perform maintenance validation tasks. Also, our test framework allows us to parallelize the test case if they don't have dependencies between them. At this stage, we already have all the tools to automate the workflow. From now, I will promise I will go quicker on the next slide. Now, it's time to synchronize our product. As I pointed out before, we need to be sure to have the latest product packages available before we test our clients, as the clients are dependent on those packages. Going into the details, we'll need to synchronize all supported platforms, but also prepare custom channels for some of the for some of them, like Ubuntu or Red Hat, which retrieves the packages from an online repository or a mounted DVD ISO. In this case, we can make use of the parallelization offered by our test framework and launch the synchronization of all products at the same time from the different web browsers. Now it's time to add our maintenance update repositories, those that will contain the newly built packages, those that we are interested to validate. We'll create custom channels for each client, injecting on them the respective maintenance update repository. All of that running in parallel and so on, we win a lot of time comparing our manual process we did before. Activation keys. The activation keys stage here, the activation keys is a SUSE Manager mechanism to ensure a group of configuration settings. So when you connect to a new client using an activation key, you ensure that SUSE Manager will provide the appropriate software channels for that kind of client. On that stage, we'll create activation keys for all our clients. And the most important part is that we need to include a custom channel which contains the new packages to validate. We will have fun bootstrapping our components now, starting by your SUSE Manager proxy. A proxy can be prepared by bootstrapping a SOL client on the proxy machine and then converting the SOL client to a proxy. So the proxy will obtain the new packages to test through a custom channel which is inside its activation key. All our clients will be handled or proxy. In that way, indirectly, will be validate the proxy works as expected. Let's bootstrap now all our clients. As you remember, our test framework can perform in parallel the steps to bootstrap all the clients. It will save a lot of time, as manually we need to do it sequentially or by splitting the clients between the team members. Finally, we will have all our clients registered in SUSE Manager. We can see them in our list of systems. Then, it's time to run some tests on them. These are the basic tests we will perform on each client. This piece of code reflects how easy it will be for non-technical people to understand what will be the steps executed. That section is what we call acceptance criteria of the feature. In our case here, what we do is to group all the basic features in one. The outcome from it will tell us if that kind of client, this platform, has passed the validation. Et voila, we completed the full workflow now, automating every stage. We can say now that we evolved from an assisted validation to an automated validation, which gives us some confidence about our new maintenance update to release. Does that mean we don't need more human resources to validate a maintenance update? False. It means that we will have more time to verify the bug fix. The bug fix introduced on that new maintenance update or perform more exploratory testing. Also, someone will need to review the test report extracted from the automated workflow and take action depending on the result if something is failing. So, automating that workflow will save us time to focus on what matters, the new changes introduced. But at the same time, to rest assured that the majority of the features are not broken. Summarizing the outcome of that project, I would like to remark three points. First, adding a new platform to our workflow is easy, because the code is templated using the same steps, the same tests for all the platforms. Also, the total time for a validation, it will be similar because we are running the test in parallel. So we can consider that we built a scalable architecture. Second, and it might be the most important outcome for team morale, is that we can focus now in the special test cases and dedicate more time into the development cycle. So being able to contribute and assist our development team in the quality of the product. For instance, during the design or implementation phase of a new feature. Finally, the most important improvement for that project has been the speed up of the maintenance update release cycle, or at least relaxing the constraints related to the time spent during the validation. There is a lot of room for improvement, but after automated the validation workflow, we reduce it to an average of 2 days that process compared to 1 week that was before. I think I already mentioned some of the tech stack we make use to carry out this automation project, but I will let you this slide with all of them. They have hyperlinks, but in case you only have the video, don't worry. Just look for those names in internet and I'm sure you will be lucky. They are very known tools. As a declarative delivery pipeline, we use Jenkins pipeline. It allows us to stop the workflow when a critical failure happens in a stage or take any action. As infrastructure as code, we use SumaForm, which is an internal tool that takes advantage of Terraform and Salt to deploy and also configure our test environment or virtual machines. This tool, by the way, is open source, so everyone has access to it. And our test framework, written in Ruby, makes use of Cucumber and Capybara to interact with the user interface and show the steps to non-technical people using natural language. Also, we use a framework called Parallel Test to perform the Cucumber test in parallel. I would like to finish this presentation without mentioning these sessions. If you embrace the DevOps culture, if you trust, as I do, the automation is the key to success, I invite you to watch these sessions. Thank you all. Thanks for giving me the possibility to share that story with you. And do not hesitate to ask me about any doubt about this adventure on the automation path.